exhort us very briefly today, because I want us to pray at some point in the service. It's actually supposed to be a full prayer service, but I want to share something with us, and I want us to pray. Acts 16:25. It's our month of divine restoration, and God has promised us restoration in this month. So I'm going to be talking along that line. Acts 16:25. I'm going to be talking about keys to divine restoration. That is what I'm talking about this evening. And there are basic things in our life. There are certain things in our life that if we can get them in place, then we have won the battles and we have gained the victories over the situations of our lives. And I trust that God will help us tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 16, verse 25. I will read from 24 so that we will get a full. Where's the Bible? Did you hear me say Acts? Acts chapter 16, verse 25, but I'll start reading from 24. Are we in Acts now? Around midnight. If your Bible is not borrowed, you can mark the word midnight. Around midnight. Somebody say midnight.
Midnight.
Are we sleeping? Somebody say midnight.
Midnight.
I can hear you clearly. Somebody say midnight.
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 Yes. When people are saying the midnight, as if you know what I want to say, that's why I said it in a low tone. Bible says from 24, so the jailer put them into the inner dungeon and clamped their feet in the stocks, talking about Paul and Silas. But verse 25 says, around midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening. I'm talking about divine keys to restoration tonight. And one of the keys we have to restoration is prayer. One of the keys to restoration is prayers. I want to tell us that no matter the promises you have, no matter the prophecies that has gone forth ahead of you, no matter the visions, no matter the dreams, no matter the plans you have, if you don't breathe it in the place of prayer, everything will become zero. The Bible declares that as soon as Zion travails, she brought forth. For those of us that have been to the labor ward, maybe as a female you have gone on to give birth, or as a man you escorted the wife or you followed the wife to the labor, you will know that 3-5 minutes before the baby comes out, that is when the cry is loudest. By the time the contraction is just coming and going, she might be doing But just about when the baby is about to come out, you might hear a scream as and they shall push, and at that point, she has to push, holding her breath, so that she can give birth to the baby alive. The Bible says, as soon as Zion travails, she brought forth a male child. What is that thing you are believing God for? What is that vision? Whatever your purpose in life has to be present in prayers. Some of us had visions. In fact, God, I was thinking about my life and I was just asking God for mercy. Back then in the university level, you said, I had the map of Africa. I used my hand to draw the map of Africa. And I put all the countries, Zambia, Congo, Cameroon, around. I know it will still come to pass. Amen. And each morning after praying, I will lay my hands, Zambia, I'm coming with you with the gospel of Christ. Congo, I was praying and that same map came to me. And I said, no, it's time to draw another map. Amen. And it's time to go back to that vision that I had. The Bible says, write the vision. Make it plain. That he may run that race. He said, the vision is on a better time. Though it's tarry. Most times we miss it in the moment of tarrying. The moment of tarrying can be boring. The moment of tarrying can be like wasting time. The moment of tarrying can be just like a useless minute to us. But at that point where the vision tarries, it is at that moment, it is at that week, it is at that month that we are supposed to break that vision in prayers. But a lot of us just sit down most times and we just wish. I wish they had taken my father 20, many years ago as a slave trade to the United Kingdom or maybe to the U.S. Maybe they would have given birth to me in the U.S. and maybe I would have been somebody different than who I am today. I wish this has happened. I wish my father was Bill Gates. I wish my mother was this. But we have seen people that came out of nowhere and made a mark in their generation. Enough of wishing. The more you wish, the more you waste your time. Because the truth is that you cannot change the person that gave birth to you.
Yes, sir.
You have come. And let me shock us more. You know, sometimes we used to say, if I come back in my next world, let me disappoint you tonight. There is nothing like next world. The Bible says, it is appointed unto man once to die. After that, judgment. It's either you face eternity with God, that is your next world, that is your next life, or it's either you face eternity with the devil, that is your next world, that is your next life. The Bible says Paul and Silas were locked in the prison. And not just that they were locked. You know, there are some people that they locked them in the prison and they are still free. They can still move about. They can still go to the window and, you know, fresh air. They were locked in the prison. Their hands were tied and their feet also were tied. And the only thing they knew how to do was to pray. If you have not been praying, don't wait till you face that situation before you pray. It may be too late. Paul and Silas did not just start praying in the prison. Paul and Silas did not just start singing and singing hymns in the prison. They must have been doing it at the backside of the desert. But when it was time for God to manifest himself through their prayers, that was the moment that God stepped in. I want to challenge us as Christians tonight. I want to challenge us as a church tonight. Don't ever take prayers for granted. Don't ever. Young, old, adult. Teach your children to pray. Many years ago, I disliked my elder sister. Let me not use the word hated. Because then she just gave her life to Christ. And there was this thing around them that was burning. But to me, I felt, I'm still young. Why will I be living this way? And then she was schooling in Zaria. She would come from Zaria for holiday and would just start getting angry. Because once it is 9 o'clock, whatever thing you are doing, you must pray for 15 minutes. Once it, wherever you are, if you like form sleep, she will wake you from that sleep and she will force you to pray for 15 minutes. Then after about 14, 15 years, at that point I felt, what kind of boring life is this? So when it's 9 o'clock, everybody is getting angry. You are going to the room. Psst, psst, didn't know those moments. If I had known, I would have taken that 15 minutes seriously. Mm. I will get angry, we'll stay sometimes, we'll stay and force us to speak in tongues. Imagine forcing a sinner to speak in tongues. You see, you don't have option. It's either you pray or you pray. Not either you pray or if you don't want to, don't want to. You know, some people say, okay, if you don't want to pray, just get out. This one is get in. You will not go out. They will lock the door. Don't go. You must sleep there, but pray. And after some few years, we started developing the habit. And the thing was coming into me gradually, but I hadn't given my life to Christ. And I went for a program. After my secondary school, I went to Lagos to visit my elder brother. And the Bishop Oyedepo had a program in the church. It was Pastor Mark Ashimolowo that was preaching that night. You know, he preached in the morning. And I attended the morning session. And I started feeling this conviction of the Holy Spirit. Give your life to Christ. It was just coming. Give your life to Christ. It was coming so strong and it was coming so heavy. Give your life to Christ. You know, as if I was going on that day, I was hearing voice. Give your life to Christ. Give your life to Christ. And they did altar call in the morning section and I didn't bother. And I went home. But while I was at home, that same voice was telling me, you need to give your life to Christ. And I remember going to the church early for the evening section. And all through the while that Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo was preaching, I didn't hear any single thing that he was talking about. If you ask me today what was the topic, I don't know. What Bible verse did he quote? I don't know. What was the basis of his message? I don't know. I was just waiting for the moment when he will make the altar call. And he finished preaching as his custom was. And funny enough, he didn't make altar call. He was walking down to his seat. Bishop Oyedepo stood up from his seat, intercepted him and told him, go and make the altar call. And he turned back because that was what I was panting for. So I knew the whole drama. I knew everything because I was gazing at them. And he turned back and climbed the altar again and made altar call. And I was the first person that ran out. And I cried out for God to help me.
Hallelujah.
I gave my life to Christ that day. And from the next day, I started praying 1 hour. It was like magic. My elder brother has made a statement I can never forget. He said, if God can save glory, God can save the devil. Mm. Because he was in the room, he heard me praying. He came, he listened. He said, is this glow that is praying? He went, I came back. He said, no. If glow, this one can, no, God can save the devil. But he didn't just jump up to 1 hour. He started from 15 minutes. From 1 hour, 3 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours. Started from somewhere. I'm not telling you that I can pray, I'm still learning. But don't wait until you are faced with a prison situation that you will cry out to God. Your prison situation may not be like Paul and Silas that were locked in a building. The stress you are going through in your academics may be your prison situation. The state of your bank account may be your prison situation. That at the end of the month, you are thinking, oh God, I have to pay the bills. That may be your prison situation. Your career may be your business that is not succeeding, may be your prison situation. Your wife, your children, they may be your prison situation. Whatever your prison situation is, don't wait until you are locked up before you learn the act of prayer, because your days in the prison may be prolonged. The Bible says, at midnight. I want to challenge. challenge us about the power of praying in the night. The power of praying in the night. A lot of transactions go on in the atmosphere at night. Even Jesus, the Bible says, a great while before day. Now, the Bible calls him the morning star. That means he is morning. But he masters the night. He is both in control of the night and in control of the morning. The Bible says, a great while before day, he will leave his brethren. Sometimes I was standing to that and I was thinking, why will Jesus pray? Now the Bible says he is at the right hand of the Father. He is making intercession for us. And now we pray in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, whatsoever thing you ask in my name, God will give it to you. Now, he is making intercession for us. Now, how will the one that is answered prayer pray? A great while before me. He goes to the Lord. Imagine if the day that Judas came to betray Jesus. That was the day Jesus started shouting, I bind you, I bind you. I mean, what would have happened?
Stop it!
It would have just been like, I don't know how to explain it. It would have been like, a foolish display. Like a child's play. Like somebody that don't know his assignment. Like somebody that doesn't know his purpose. He said, I know why I was born. He said, for this reason I came to die. For this reason I came to the world. No wonder he said, you do what you want to do quickly. I know what I came to do. I have prayed it up. I have sorted it out. No wonder at Gethsemane he cried out, Father, not my will, but let your own will be done. He got to the stage that he prayed. His sweat became blood. Some of us are facing situations in our lives and we are sleeping. The Bible says a little sleep. A little. It didn't say much. Now, when the Bible says a little, what is little? Maybe 1 hour? Maybe 2 hours? Some of us are sleeping much sleep. The Bible says a little sleep, a little slumber. A little folding of your hands. It says, so shall your poverty come, like an armed man. Some of us are not just sleeping a little sleep. Some of us are sleeping much
sleep.
Much. That means your poverty will come with AK-47. Armor tank. Ballistic missile. Abi? Intercontinental ballistic. I pray that God will help us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Seize the night. The Bible told us about the 5 wise virgins and the 5 foolish virgins. The Bible says, at midnight, a cry went out. When all the shops have closed, probably. When there was no helper on the road, probably. When there was no savior on the road, probably. When little or no preparation has been done, unexpectedly, folding of arms, a cry went out. Go out to meet the bridegroom. That was when they realized that they had not prayed enough. That was when they realized that they don't have enough oil. The oil speaks of anointing. And it is in the place of prayer that you get anointing. Let no man deceive you. I believe in laying of hands. Eh? I believe in spiritual fathers, transference. But it can only release a blessing to a certain degree on you. If not, every other person will be anointed. Because some people just go out and say, give me anointing.
No.
Say, take.
Give me anointing. You're someone the Bible, Peter said, your money perish with you. You think we buy this, we bought this thing with money? Come, let me show you the sky. Let me show you. Let me show you the place of prayer. Let me show you how we stay in the upper room and pray. Let me show you. You want to give me money? Say, your money perish with you. Suddenly they realized. Came in contact with a destiny that they had opportunity to prepare for, but they were not prepared for. Just like some of us at this point of our life, it's like a birthing season for us. You are supposed to be in the place of that word. As Apostle Suleiman said something, he says, you were born with a destiny. He said, because you have failed to pray, your destiny has lost expression. He said, and you can only give prophetic word expression in the place of prayer. He said, no matter who gives you a prophecy, he said, open me that is talking to you. I may call your name, call your number, and give you a prophecy. He said, after I leave here, go and bet it out in prayer. Don't just say, I came to Scotland and I prayed and I've gone. Father, I'm waiting for it to be fulfilled. He said, I'm sorry. It may not be fulfilled. He said, give your prophecy expression in the place of prayer. And he made a statement that changed my life. He said, one quality hour of prayer in the midnight will do more work than 4 hours of praying in the day. Why? Because a lot of things go on in the atmosphere in the night. Any man that can master his night spiritually can master his day. And let me tell you, the spiritual controls the physical. You can wake up in the night and speak into the heavens. A man of God calls it commanding your morning. You can wake up in the night and speak into your heavens and take charge over the atmosphere. When you wake up in the morning, you just go for interview and they give you the job. When you wake up in the morning, you just say, carelessly, let me check my account. If something happened to me last week, I don't know what happened. Something wrong with travel. I was like, okay, car insurance and tax is in one account. I was like, this thing was so dumb. Let me just check. I know there was nothing in that particular account. Yes. I said, but let me just, at about 12, let me just check. And I just opened the account. I saw transfer, £40. I looked at it. Honestly, I never asked that person for money. I was not expecting. I was like, okay, let me check how much is in this account so I can transfer from the other account to this account to balance what is coming up for car insurance and road tax. I saw I already have more than half of the money. And that I just picked my phone and said, thank you very much. God bless you. You can pray in the night and you begin to see miracles in the morning. Bible says, who are you, O mountain, to stand before somebody? With prayers, you can be made. Amen. I trust that God will help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Pray in your understanding. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Let me do not praying in the Holy Ghost. Bible declares that we know what we should pray for, that we ought to, but it is a spirit in us that maketh intercession. The Holy Spirit helps us to pray. If you try to pray in your understanding, you are limited. But there are some things that you want to say. As soon as the Holy Spirit steps in and starts helping you to make that intercession, before you know, you begin to see that you are getting victory. You are getting victory. You are getting victory. We see little result in prayers because we pray so much in our understanding.
Amen.
We see little result in prayers because we pray without power. Some of us want to pray to God, we are speaking phonetics. Oh God. Good morning, Lord.
Yeah.
What's up? My sister went to one church. In fact, they invited her to come and preach at church, but she's coming to Scotland very soon.
Amen.
They invited her to come and preach. And immediately she got to the stage. No, before they called her, the person that was like the MC for the program, whatever, he said, love you, give Jesus a wiper. Well, Latin Africa, really. You know, and everybody started, woo-hoo, woo-hoo, woo-hoo. My sister sat down. You know, when you go to a program with fire to preach, and the atmosphere just fizzles the fire, then you start praying again, like, God, you have to help me preach. Said, give Jesus a wiper. And she was like, Jesus, a wiper. And then, ooh, 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 ooh. She was like, oh God. She felt so disappointed. By the time she got to the altar, that was the first issue she addressed. Jesus is not your mate. You don't play with Jesus. The Bible says, lift up holy hands. You don't walk the name of Jesus in the name of worship. And by the time she finished with him, to pray, we don't know how to pray. We say things that we don't even understand. Of course, say people saying things that we just imbibe it and start saying things you don't know. We trust that God will help us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The best way to pray is to pray in the Holy Ghost. Because even before you start praying, God knows what you want to say. Before you go say, in the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you, He knows how you end the prayer. The Bible says the Holy Spirit, He helps us. Even the things that you cannot even remember, even the things that you want to say that you cannot say. Pastor Suleiman just came from South Africa. He said that is the shortest message he has ever preached. Thank you, Jesus. He said, for 7 days, I prayed in tongues for 10 hours. With his busy schedule. He was like, I said, this man. When you see, I'm talking about him because I want to know what is driving this man. He said, 10 hours for 70, 70 hours in 10 days of praying in tongues alone. We're not talking about the hour he spends reading the Bible. He said, immediately he got to South Africa and climbed the stage. Thank you, Jesus. 41 people first from wheelchair. He said, countless blind eyes.
Yes.
He said, come here, come here. He said, you don't pray, you missed. Praying in the Holy Ghost. There's nothing as sweet as praying in the Holy Ghost. Most of when you start praying in English and speaking all the phonetics, you know how to say, you check your time. 5 minutes. Jesus, I saw this thing. Father, I thank you. You are God. Hey, Jesus. Hey, hey, hey. And you divide Red Sea. You are the one that did man. Hey, God. God, okay, Father, you are faithful. I just thank you for this morning. How many minutes? 10 minutes. But by the time you go, legals are there. Pradu Shadava Agelete Impradu Zadada. Before you know, it's sweet. It's sweet. I've prayed and prayed and prayed the tongues to a level that you can't stop. There was a time I so much prayed the tongues that even if I want to pray for food, legals are like, I lose sight of praying in English. We will go to the mountain in school. We will stay 6 hours under the rain, under the sun. We are praying in tongues. And if there's anything I desire now, I desire such days again. I will never say then. I'm believing God for now. God, take me back to those moments. Whatever thing that has stolen my prayer life, God, take me back to those moments of prayers. And I can tell you, I know what prayers has done.
Yes.
Not just prayers, praying in the Holy Ghost. I trust that God will help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The second thing I want to talk about very quickly is praise. Praise. Some of us don't know how to praise. Some of us don't know how to sing. Let me ask you a question. There was something Pastor said one time. He said we should go and start learning hymn. And he started it. He started singing. He said sometimes he will just start singing before you know 2 hours he has sang. Now let me ask you a question. You say you are a Christian. You don't know how to sing on earth. What will you be doing in heaven? Will you be just looking at the saints of God and worshiping and singing to God? Or what will you be doing? You'll be tending the garden. Or what will you be doing? I want to challenge us as a church. You may not have the best of voice. We are not talking about voice. We are not talking about auto, bass, tenor. We are not talking about all those things. Learn to praise God. Learn to sing. I stood somewhere a few days ago and I was just singing. I was dancing. I didn't know some white men were looking at me. And hey! I heard them say, it's a good day for her. It's a good day for her.
Yes.
It's a good day for her. I was singing. I was singing. I think Kevin was looking behind me. I was singing. I was singing loud. I was walking on the street singing, speaking in tongues in town center recently, a few days ago, speaking in tongues. People were just looking at me and saying, people don't understand. You can smoke in the public, I can sing in the public. You can drink on the pub, I can do my own on the streets. Bible says, Paul and Silas, they prayed and they sang. After praying, what next? Singing. Sometimes you don't know, that phone you have is not just for text message and missed calls. Put YouTube, put songs and praise. Sometimes 2 hours at night, I'm on redeem praise. FOL 2011. Listen to that praise. We wanna see Jesus lifted high. The banner that flies, I sing it in the night across Forgewood. That all men may see the truth and know. That is what I believe. That is the gospel I preach. And it has a prophetic side to it. Step by step, we are moving forward. Little by little, we're gaining ground. That's a prophetic word for you. If you don't know how to sing, put music, sing, dance. Sometimes I dance. After dancing at 2 a.m., I go to take my bath because I sweat. I'm telling you, most times 2 a.m., 2:30, I go to bed because I can't go back. Sweat still will be dripping like this. Hot praise, 2 hours. Sometimes I put Sinatra and worship him. Great are you, Lord. Greatly to be praised. Father, you reign. You just praise him. You just tell him who he is. You just praise him in the place of prayer. You just honor him. You just acknowledge him. You just dance before him. David danced until his wife mocked him. As some of us haven't called ourselves David, some of us have called our children David. You don't have anything that looks like David in you. Pastor said we come to church, he will force us to say, he will say, praise the Lord. He will force us to say, hallelujah. We don't look like Christians. If you have the joy of the Lord, before somebody says, praise the Lord, you are already shouting, hallelujah. Have you seen people that go to God? If the DJ mistakenly puts off the music, that something happened, music go off. You will start getting all the F, all the you start. That is when the owner of that pub will know that people came to praise the devil. But we that say we are Christians, we that say we have the message of life. So what's going to just in our life? I don't understand why you cannot sing. I don't understand why you cannot pray. I don't understand why you cannot dance. I don't understand it. Create your own atmosphere. I'm telling you these things today because my elder sister that taught me to pray, this is somebody that will stand for 9 hours, she's speaking in tongues. Oh God. She's not here with me today. But I'm giving this to my God till she has done for me. To God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
own father, that woman will lose.
Your mother may not be there tomorrow. Your siblings will not be there. You may be standing on your own. But let it be that wherever you are standing, you have a testimony of good reports. Wherever you are standing, wherever you are standing in life, where your parents are not there, where your father is, where your mentors are not there, let it be that you have a good reward.
Apostle Sullivan said something in one of his speeches after warning the Kaduna State government. He said, "But you pastors, make sure your hands are clean." See, because whatever thing that's happening, if your hands are soiled, if you take bribe, if you do this, if you do that, then you are on your own. But we are defending the faith. We are defending Christianity. But make sure, I beg you, make sure that your hands are clean. Archbishop Percy, that also has blessed memory, his spiritual father, he's not there today to stand with you. But he's standing with testimonies of good report. I trust that God will help us in the name of Jesus. The second key is, the third key, and that is our round of this evening, to restoration is thanksgiving. Philippians 4, verse 6. That's our round of this. Philippians 4, verse 6.
Says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer.
Hold it, sir. You see that prayer is coming back. Bible says, be anxious for nothing. Worry about nothing. And he went on to say, with prayer, yes, sir.
And supplication. With thanksgiving.
With thanksgiving. Yes, sir.
Let your request be made known to God.
Yes, sir.
7. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guide your heart and mind through Christ Jesus.
Amen. Be anxious for nothing. Instead of getting anxious, the Bible is saying, pray. Instead of getting anxious, the Bible is saying, give thanks. Father, I thank you for you are faithful. There's one song that my late pastor used to sing. Every time he sings that song, I wonder, why is Bishop T always singing this song? If you are driving with him in the car, before you know, he starts singing. I thank you, Lord. I thank you for before. I thank you for today. I thank you for always. I mean, he always sings the song. A heart of thanksgiving. Father, I thank you for your... So if us often go to bed, we wake up in the morning, we can't say, thank you, Father. You think it's by your power? You think it's by your might? So if us have headache and we lay our house to ourselves and we pray and it gets... A lot of people have died of headache if you don't know. A lot of people have died of stomach ache if you don't know. A lot of people have gone into financial crisis and they just took their lives. Hey, I cannot be. They just took their lives and they died. And you slept. And you woke up. You can't say, Father, I thank you. You ate food and you did not eat poison. You cannot say, Father, I thank you. You went to the shop to buy your very good clothes that fitted you. You cannot say, Father, I thank you. You did a business and you succeeded. You cannot say, Father, I thank you. Some of us that have children, how many times have we told God, Father, I thank you for my name is not mentioned among the barren people.
Hallelujah.
We went for a program and by a prophetic word, the man of God called out a woman. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 21 years of waiting for fruit of the womb. And I said to myself,
Sometimes you just need to put yourself in some people's shoes.
Yes.
And I said to myself, if it is me, what will I be doing? What if the man has left the woman? Say, no, I cannot take it, let me go. And those kind of people, they may go and meet another person and the person will get pregnant. And you will still be there, oh, you had the cause, you had the cause. How many times have you looked at your children and said, Father, they are not yet what I want them to be. I know they will become it. Father, I thank you.
Yes.
How many times have you looked at the 2x2 bedrooms you are staying? I say, Father, I know I am moving to that good place. I am moving to that mansion. But for this place that, you don't understand, the first time I came to Scotland, from Nigeria to Morocco, from Morocco to London Heathrow, from London Heathrow by bus, National Express, it was like 42 hours marathon journey. I had to be running. My husband was calling me. You have 30 minutes from when the plane stops to pass immigration. If you miss that flight, you just start trekking to London from Morocco. So as far as that plane is, bah, see, bah, bah, I was moving. 30 minutes to pass immigration, you know the queue.
Watch out.
I moved, he said, London. Meanwhile, I got to London, I was tired. He said, now you have only 45 minutes to pass London immigration. SN, or National Express, if it moves, you are finished. I was like, oh, this thing is tiring. Marathon. At the time, he was calling me. At the time, no network. I couldn't call him. He couldn't call me. He was worried if I had missed the bus, or if immigration had picked me, or whatever. Of course, I came legally. So, no, no. But they just told me that there's some way you just talk. They'll just tell you to go back. So he wasn't communicating to me again at London Heathrow. I couldn't get him. I mean, there was